Number four, letter A. The springs of a pickup truck act like a single spring with a force constant of 1.3 times 10 to the 5 newtons per meter. By how much will the truck be depressed by its maximum load of 1,000 kilograms? All right, so this is fairly straightforward. We're going to be using Hooke's law. All right, so it says that the force that the spring produces on an object will be equal to the negative of its spring constant multiplied by the change in displacement of that particular spring. So we'll assume that the truck is, we'll assume the spring, you know, there's like a weighing station here, there's a certain spring, blah, 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 blah. And then all of a sudden, the spring will become depressed when the truck goes on it, okay? So the change in displacement here will be negative, all right? As you can see, because the initial is higher than the final. All right, so anyway, moving forward. So we're trying to find the force constant, right? The spring constant, tomato, tomato. So we'll solve this thing for K. So K is going to be equal to negative F over then the change in displacement. So the force, right, F sub S really represents the force that the spring exerts on the object, okay? So if we look at this particular picture over here and you were to draw a free body diagram of it, you would know that the truck has a certain weight, right? And the truck's weight is pushing down, the weight of the truck. But what's pushing up on it then? If there was only one force vector pointing down, it would be unbalanced, and therefore we would have a positive sum of the force, well, or a negative here. We would have a negative acceleration. Something's got to balance it. You know that it's not going anywhere. So there has to be, this is the force that the spring's producing. It's opposite, right, in the direction. So in other words, what we need to do is we have to then take, right, noticing this, that the weight of the truck is basically equal to but opposite in sign of the force that the spring exerts. So when I look at this and I say the sum of the force in the y direction equals zero, the force of the spring minus, I'm taking that negative into account, the weight of the truck is equal to zero. That means the force of the spring equals the weight of the truck. I mean, simple. So now what I realize is I can simply do a little substitution here, right? I can say that instead of the force of the spring, or the force that the spring exerts on the object, I can simply plug in now the weight of the truck. Do not plug in a double negative there, otherwise the signs won't really make sense. Divided by then the change in displacement. So now simply, I can plug in the values, right? The weight of the truck, how do we find that? Well, it's the mass of the truck, which is 1,000, they told us, times 9.8. That's easy. Divided then by the displacement. Now, no, remember, the displacement's negative, okay? So we're trying to actually, oh, what am I doing? Did I really solve this for the wrong thing, guys? You were supposed to be screaming. I'm sure you were screaming at me already. So my apologies on that. Let's plug in that value since we, let's not plug in that value since we actually don't know it. Okay, we do not know it. So instead, we know the K, right? So, just seeing if you're paying attention, and I'm sure you were. So good catch. So let's just solve this for change in displacement because that's what we need. So it's going to be negative 1,000 times 9.8, all divided by then 1.3 times 10 to the fifth, and the change in displacement negative, which it should be because it went down. So negative 0.0754, and that is going to be in terms of meters, right? So that works out to be about 7.54 centimeters. All right, we'll leave it at that. And now that takes care of letter A, and then letter B simply now is if the pickup truck has four identical springs, what is the force constant of each? Okay, so the force, so now we have to think about, well, how does that affect then the change in displacement, right? Or the force, basically. Well, you can think about this. Instead of the force, you know, there is a linear, if you notice also in the formula, F is equal to negative kx, it's basically a linear relationship, right? It's not exponential or quadratic of any form. So we know that we'll have a proportional, basically, exactly proportional relationship here. And what we then realize is that if this is the total force, right, that the spring is exerting, but now that's the total force, but that's divided up into four springs, right? Well, then what is the force constant of each of those four springs? Well, it'd simply be divided by four because it's a proportional change, all right? I'm just going to write that out. So essentially what we could say is that the force on a single spring, or the force a single spring produces, will be equal to the negative spring constant of that single spring multiplied by the change in then displacement of that spring. The displacement isn't changing, right? Because it's still being displaced by negative 7.5 centimeters or so. But what's different is now the force on that single spring. right? It's basically going to be 1/4, since there's four springs, 1/4 of the mass of the truck, right? Multiplied then by gravity is equal to negative the spring constant multiplied by change in displacement. So I can solve for this now, all right? And that's kind of basically what I was trying to mention, that the spring constant here is going to then be equal to negative change in displacement, all divided by then, and all divided now by thinking about the math. So this is, sorry, this is not up there. That's why I'm like, wait a minute, something's not making sense. So solving for this, my apologies, is going to be 1/4 negative times the mass of the truck times gravity, all divided by then the change in displacement. So plugging this all in, and you can see it works. It's going to work out to be 1/4, right, of the value. So let me just plug everything in. Negative 1/4 times the mass of the truck, which was 1,000, times gravity, which is 9.8, and then divide that whole thing now by the displacement, which is, again, negative 0.0754 that we just found. And we can just simply plug it in. So we're going to take 0.25 multiplied by 1,000 times 9.8 and divide it now by that exact value that we got before. And it'll come out to be positive, right? So this is about, this is going to be 3.25 times 10 to the 3/4. And that's, again, newtons per meter, okay? You could have also simply literally just taken the spring constant that was given, right, the force constant, just have divided that by 4. Do it. 1.3 times 10 to the 5th and divided by 4. And look, you got the same answer. All right? So, guys, thanks for tuning in. Appreciate it very much. Please remember to help us out and subscribe, and we'll see you next time. Take care.